Reddit. What is something that happened at a sleepover which you will never forget? I was in preschool and sleeping at a friend's house down the street with my sister. In the middle of the night I woke up to screaming and glass shattering, so I got out of bed and followed the noise into the lounge room. His parents were screaming at each other and throwing things around the room, and when they saw me the mother came running over and pushed me back into the bedroom and shut the door. Not something I'll forget anytime soon. When we were about 15, my buddy stole some alcohol from his parents and invited me over to drink it with him. When I got there I went to take a shit and was only gone about 5 minutes, and when I came back, he drank almost all of it. I called him an asshole and drank the bit that was left, which actually got me a good buzz. We decided to watch a movie and I noticed he wasn't looking good. Then he puked all over the floor. His mom was downstairs and I didn't want to get caught, so I started cleaning it up. But he kept puking like 3 other piles. I got him to the bathroom and he looked at me and said, "Guess what?" I said, "What?" And he started peeing his pants and then laughed like it was the funniest thing in the world. I got him back to his bed and he bathed again. This was like the 4th or 5th pile and I'd only gotten one cleaned up, and not cleaned up very well. I was kinda drunk. He got out of bed and took his piss-soaked pants and underwear off and was looking for new pants, and I decided that I'd had enough. I wasn't going to deal with barf and a drunk naked person who was doing nothing to help the situation. On my way out the door I told his mom he wasn't feeling well and left. When I got home my parents knew I was drunk and grounded me. His mom blamed everything on me and called my parents to tell them that I got her little angel drunk. My friend just screamed in the middle of the night. I heard it because I had trouble sleeping in a bed that wasn't my own. He just fucking yelled out. In hindsight he was probably just having a dream and sleep talking slash yelling, but when I was 8 it was kinda terrifying. I was around 7 years old. I had a rich friend named Kevin who could afford all sorts of cool toys because his dad imported and exported them along with other goods. During one sleepover, he brought over one of those remote control fart boxes. Instead of playing with it, we hatched a master plan to sneak it under my parents' bed and unleash its power when they were going to bed. We waited for hours. Finally, when the clock struck midnight, we let it loose. PHHHFFFFFFRTTT. Goddam, Alden. My mother. But it wasn't over. We didn't spam. We waited for them to settle and let it go again and again. Finally we couldn't take it anymore. My parents had heard us cracking up and my dad, as boisterous with his colon as he is, realized it wasn't his ass. My friend got a sext from his mom that was meant for her boyfriend. It specifically said the boyfriend's name in it, so I'm certain it wasn't an incest thing. The look on his face and the graphic detail in the text was the funniest fucking thing I have ever witnessed. I couldn't fall asleep because I was laughing for hours. Another kid and I got into the same sleeping bag and touched our dicks together because we thought it would mean we had lost our virginities. The other boys sat in a circle around us, egging us on. It was actually a lot like the last scene of Requiem for a Dream. TL, Doctor, Dick to Dick. In 10th grade, my friend threw a small party at her house because her parents were gone for the week. Fast forward to 3 a.m. I'm in bed with her, she's fully asleep, while I'm still fully awake. There's something making a faint noise to my left, my friend is sleeping on the right side of the bed. I turn my head to the left, and I see it. It's a little blonde girl. Her skin is blue, or a negative. She has a white pyjama dress and she's holding a teddy bear. Classic unoriginal ghost stuff. But I swear I panicked. I went under the covers. I hear her coming next to me. The faint sound that I had heard was her breathing. The left side of my head, shoulder and arm got cold. I start shaking my friend, so she wakes up. I say, "Anna, there's a fucking ghost in your room." All sleepy she replies, "Just ignore her and she'll leave." What? The little girl left after 2 minutes. I didn't sleep all night. Next morning, my friend tells me that sometimes the ghost comes to her room or in the basement at night. I know some people don't believe in ghosts, but this was one of the most terrifying things I've experienced. There's no logical explanation. My cousin awoke to her friend's dad sucking on her toes. I wet the bed at a friend's house one time. The next morning, I told him that I grabbed lemonade from the fridge in the middle of the night and spilled a whole cup. I was like 8. They didn't have lemonade. First time I ever saw porn was at a sleepover and it totally blew my mind. Had no idea that there was this whole world of sexual possibilities beyond like awkwardly humping my pillow. Slept at friend's house. Friend has cat. Woke up with cat sleeping on face. I panic. Cat panics because I'm panicking. Cat claws my face. I have hated cats ever since. Okay, not a sleepover technically, but more of a trip away. My class went to a trip away, and the boys slept in one room and girls another. Now on one of the last days of the week-long trip, one of the boys in my class decided it would be a great idea for all of us to wank together at the same time. So a group of 17 boys wanking furiously in sleeping bags was definitely one of the most WTF am I doing moments of my life. We were 13 over 14 at the time, and that is a moment I will never forget. I had a big birthday party sleepover when I was 11 or 12 and invited a bunch of my friends to spend the night. My mom made me invite the kid from down the road, who was in my grade, but I never really noticed him. He was really small and took a lot of medicine. Anyway, he wet the bed that night and was humiliated by everyone there, including me. I saw him on the bus the following week, and I felt bad about what happened. We became best friends and hung out most weekends until the end of high school. He told me that he had a liver transplant in kindergarten and was facing some serious health threats in the future. We remained close, and last summer his liver failed and he passed away in hospice care at the age of 25. TL, doctor, weird neighbor kid pissed the bed, became best friends until his passing. Was about 8 or 9 years old at my mate's house watching The Exorcist. My mate's dad thought it would be funny to go outside and lift the window shutters up and scream through the window. Fucking terrifying. Had a party for my 13th birthday with a bunch of mates. We all slept in the lounge room in sleeping bags. By about 2 a.m. one of the guys had fallen asleep. So we decided the only suitable course of action was to mess with him. Thankfully he was a sleep talker, so this made things super easy. After making him respond to ridiculous comments and making him sing the original Pokemon theme while we were all trying to laugh silently so as not to wake up parents, my friend, we'll call him Ben because that was his name, started clicking in his ear. Andrew, the sleeper, said out loud, "Stop clicking your fingernails, sister's name," which obviously caused Ben to do it more. So, still sleeping, Andrew decides the best way to retaliate is to take a swing at his sister, socking Ben square in the face in the process. It took 4 of us to hold Ben back from killing Andrew, who rolled over and let out a snore, blissfully unaware of the situation. He had barely escaped from intact. When I was a kid, my mom had a friend who would always bring her son over to hang out. Anyways, they arranged a sleepover for us that he was especially stoked about. So it's lights out, and he almost immediately starts crying. He kept saying my mom wanted a girl over and over. I'm still not sure what the happened. Not particularly eventful or sexy, but when I was in middle school, my friend had a birthday party sleepover with about 8 to 10 girls. Around 10 p.m. we decide to all sneak out and go TP some boys' house. We go and TP the house. Then we realize we are lost and don't know how to get back to her house. So, we find the closest main road and start walking down it. About 8 to 10 middle school girls in their PJs. So, naturally a police officer stops us and asks what we are doing out so late. Must have been a really awesome cop, because we make up some stupid story about looking for a lost cat. We all pile in the car, and he takes us back to her house, where we ask him to turn off the lights and let us walk up. I used to be best friends with the popular girl at school, and our group of friends had sleepovers all the time. One night when we were around 12 years old, I woke up all wet, and she convinced me that it was really hot, and we had just sweated a lot. Then I started to think about the plastic cover on her bed and frequent sheet changing. And it all made sense. She had peed the bed, and, well, me. I stepped on the baby's head. Never figured out why the baby was on the floor in the middle of the night, but it scared the crap out of me. The baby was fine. Friend's birthday party, I was 12. I took a giant shit, flushed the toilet and walked away. An hour later his mom yelled from the bathroom, OMF, there's shit everywhere. The five of us went to the bathroom, see a thin layer of water and runny shit all over the floor with his mom angrily staring at us. Everyone knew it was me and pointed it out immediately. I was never allowed at his house again. I still run into his mom sometimes, and I can tell she still isn't over it. We were all around 8 to 10 years old, and it's about 11 p.m. After spending all day with the birthday boy's aunt, his legal guardian, we are watching Wild Wild West when out of nowhere one of the boys says to my friend's aunt, "You have great knockers." She said thank you, and we all continued watching the movie. We were a bunch of 10-year-old girls. Immediately one girl became the group bitch, I forget how, but after she fell asleep we all tried to put her fingers in water. She didn't pee, so we decided to just fuck with her and move her in her sleep so she'd wake up on the coffee table and not know how she got there. She woke up as we were attempting to transport her and had a surprisingly good attitude about it. Then we all felt kind of bad. When I was 7 years old, me and my best friend back then heard gunshots outside his house late one night. It wasn't a completely unusual occurrence, so we didn't think much of it until we went outside the morning after and found his dog had been hit by one of the bullets. I, female, made out with a girl for the first time. We both had boyfriends. Neither of them were there. She was very religious and cried afterwards. Both of our boyfriends forgave us. Later realized I'm not straight. I was 8 or 9, spending the night at a friend's house for her birthday. All the other girls were asleep, but I couldn't sleep. I was bored, so I went to the bathroom and started playing with her mom's Macup and hair care products. What's the worst that could happen, right? Well, I got a chunk of my coarse, curly hair stuck in a round hairbrush. I could not for the life of me get it out, and I was too afraid to go rummaging around in her kitchen for scissors, because I didn't want to wake the other girls up. So I pulled out my hair. A chunk of hair, about 3 inches wide. I pulled it all out, crying silently the whole time, and then spent the rest of the night picking my hair out of the hairbrush with blood rolling down my forehead. It was traumatic. My conclusion: sleepovers are dangerous. In my 20s, I threw a sleepover. I invited a guy that I intended to set up with a friend. Turns out my friend went back to her ex. I become great friends with guy. That guy is now my husband. Best sleepover ever. Staying the night at a friend's house with a bunch of our buddies when we were all in our mid-teens. We're all sleeping on the floor in this large room, fairly spaced apart, almost zero light. The slightly older sister of the friend whose house it was had been flirting with one of the guys all night, and while we were all asleep she snuck into the room. I think I was the only one still awake. From what I could make out in the darkness, she crawled over to the guy she'd been flirty with, slid under his blanket, got on top of him, and started grinding away. He had the biggest grin the next morning, but would answer, "I'm just happy to be here with you guys," whenever asked. My best friend from ages 7 to 14 was a very tomboyish girl, and one time, when I was around 11, I was sleeping over her house. This time, two of her attractive female cousins happened to be there for the evening as well. I forget how it came up, but they started talking about how they had never seen a penis, and were asking me to show them. Now, I was a shy kid, and raised by very conservative parents, so this took a little bit of persuading, but after an hour of them asking, we went into her bedroom, shut the door, and I whipped it out,